yung pinakamabagal na component sa computer setup ay hindi yung computer. It's you. Yung primary interface kasi natin, palagi through the GUI. And that's usually mouse-based na sobrang bagal. Para bumilis yung interaction natin sa computer, kailangan natin ng shortcut. Hayop na hardware sugar na yan! Clickbait na naman! Ctrl-W dapat sa'yo. Pero teka, ganun ka-useful yung mga keyboard shortcuts. Ctrl-W is for browsers to immediately close the tab that you're using. Kung may pinapanood ka at di mo dapat pinapanood, biglang may dumating, Ctrl-W will save your life. Sa video na to, pag-usapan natin yung iba't ibang keyboard shortcuts and how they can save you time and hassle. Sobrang useful, but it's just not a question of speed. You can literally do more because you have so many other different commands at your fingertips. Pero bago nun, yung shortcut talaga to hassle-free productivity is activating Windows using a CD key from our sponsor. Makulit yan si Windows. Out of the blue, magre-reklamo na, uy, activate mo naman ako. And usually, those reminders come at the worst possible time. In the zone ka na magtrabaho, ready to tackle that contract in Word, do the bookkeeping in Excel, game na game ka na, tas masisira ang momentum mo kasi kunilit ka ni Windows. May ilang customization features din na naka-disable kung unactivated yung Windows. PC stands for personal computer, pero masasabi mo ba talaga na personal yung computer mo kung kahit yung wallpaper hindi mo mabago? Buti na lang, madali lang bumili ng activation code from our sponsor. If you've ever bought anything online, ganun din yung drill dito. Gawa ka ng account, punta ka sa tamang product link, which is in our description below. Don't forget gamitin yung discount code natin, HS20, to get a discount upon checkout. Usual payment options, you get the key, plug in the key into Windows, and you're good to go. Sobrang straightforward, no mas, no fuss. We use this sponsor a lot for the needs of the shop. So yung recommendation namin, hindi porkit sponsor nila tong video na to, but it's really based on personal experience. Naka ilang keys kami from them, and in fact, the last time we bought from them was just a few days ago from the shooting of this video. So we really use them for the shop. Alright, activated na si Windows and you can't wait to be more productive. Para sa beginners tong video na to, so just a quick note na yung mga shortcuts are composed of at least two keys. To activate them, hold down the first key and then press the second key. Dun sa nabanggit kanina, Ctrl-W, hold Ctrl and then W. Yung ibang shortcuts later will use three keys. Ganun din, hold down the first two keys and then press the third key. Pwede din naman all at the same time. Pindutin mo yung Ctrl-W, both keys at the same time. But it's just a lot easier and hindi makakasama if you hold down the first key and then just press the second key. For full-size keyboards, usually you have two of the special keys on both sides. So yung Shift, Alt, Control, meron sa kaliwa, meron sa kanan, kahit ano don. When I mention Control or any of other buttons, as long as you see it on the keyboard, you can press it. It doesn't matter which side you press. Pero usually, for convenience, yung left yung ginagamit mo. Because your left hand can reach for both Ctrl and W and most of the other keys that we'll be using. Yung keyboard na ginamit natin pang demo ng mga shortcut na to is the ROG Strix Flare 2 Animate. Pero gagana siya regardless kung anong keyboard mo. So nabanggit yung Ctrl-W kanina. This will work with most browsers. Personally, nasubukan ko na siya sa Chrome, Firefox, and Brave, pati sa Edge. Ganun kahirap yung research para sa video na to na binuksan ko yung Edge para sa inyo. Next shortcut, Alt-F4, this will close the program. So for example, nakabukas browser mo, ang daming tabs, puro kalokohan, biglang may pumasok, Ctrl-W won't help you kasi hindi mo masara lahat ng tabs in time, yari ka pa rin. Alt-F4 will immediately close the program. And this works not just for browsers, but basically for any Windows program. Kahit naka-full screen yan, for example, you're playing a game, tas nag-Alt-F4 ka, usually magka-close yung program. Alt-Tab switches between the different active programs, and this is really useful kung naka-single monitor setup ka. Usually with single monitors, palagi naka-full screen yung program. This one, you can easily toggle between the different programs. Let's say, browser mo, tapos Word, or Windows Explorer. and then Paint or Photoshop. All Tab lets you cycle quickly between programs instead of having to drag down your mouse to select the program dun sa taskbar sa ilalim. Useful din to kung naglalaro ka tapos kailangan mo mag-tab out or to exit the program briefly para pumunta ka sa OBS to set up the recording or biglang may work thing so pinos mo yung game, tab out to access the work thing and then balik ka sa game. So really useful in any setup. Control S is my favorite shortcut of all time. Sobrang lifesaver to. Usually in productivity apps like Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Paint, etc. A lot, anything where data needs to be saved, Control S will save that data. Kahit wala kang ginawa, kahit wala ka pang binabago, kahit 15 minutes ka lang nakatunga nga sa screen at blanco pa siya, mag-Control S ka. Dapat parang muscle memory mo na yon. It should be as automatic as breathing. Kasi hindi mo alam, palaging may nangyayari. Mawala yung internet, mawala yung kuryente, mag-fail bigla hard drive mo, Windows decides to reboot for some reason, at least naka-save yung data mo. If there's one shortcut you should remember from this video, it is Control S. Control Alt Delete is the killer shortcut. Dati, pumupunta ka kaagad sa Windows taskbar when you would Control Alt Delete. And from the taskbar, pwede mo na patayin or shut down or close any program. Kahit not responding program pa yan. Usually, tiklop yan sa task manager. Medyo na nerf yung Control Alt Delete ngayon kasi when you do it now in Windows 10, you actually get presented with different options. Pwede mong i-shut down, pwede ka pumunta sa task manager. So it's not as immediate as it was before. Usually yung progression nun, if you need to kill a program, you use Alt F4 first. Kung ayaw talaga, kung makulit si program, then dun ka pupunta sa task manager via Control Alt Delete. Actually, there's a new shortcut or bago siya for me. Yun nga, sanay ako sa Control Alt Delete. Pero there is a shortcut to get to task manager directly and that's Control Shift Escape. So if it's not responding to Alt F4, Control Shift Escape, punta ka sa task manager and usually you can end the program from there. Next up, yung mga combo shortcut. Control C and Control V. Control C is copy and Control V is paste. These two are literally the cornerstone of the modern economy. Isipin mo how much time is saved na kaya na ilipat yung data na ganun kabilis. Just highlight anything you need, Control C to copy, go to the other program that you will be pasting it in, then Control V, and just like that, it's amazing. All of that data instantly portable. It also works for files, moving it from one folder to another. It will even work for pictures, let's say from sa browser, and then ipipaste mo inside Word. Parang masama yung reputation ng term na copy and paste, pero sobrang useful talaga niya. Another great combo is Control Z and Control Y. Undo and redo. Let's say nagsusulat ka ng email. You want to erase what you type, but you don't want to have to select and backspace. Just press Control Z. Pero di ka mapakali. Gusto mo ipadala yung email na yan. Instead of having to type it out all over again, press Control Y. Redo. Habang malakas pa loob mo, padala mo na yung email na yan. Press Control Enter. Send that email, bro. These next shortcuts were recommended by our viewers and yun yung maganda sa shortcut. Depende sa program na ginagamit mo, depending ano yung mga naalala mo, it's really very personalized. Or iba-ibang tao, iba-iba yung favorite shortcuts na ginagamit. If you need to take a screenshot of the whole screen or a portion of the screen, you can press Windows key Shift S. That brings up the snipping tool. Sobrang useful, let's say nagpadala ka ng payment, tapos you need to take a screenshot of the confirmation, tapos i-viber mo dun sa binayaran mo. So many reasons why you would need a screenshot. Windows key Shift S allows you to take a customized screenshot. Mahalaga yung customized or just a portion of your screen. Kasi let's say, nag-transfer ka ng payment online, tapos ayaw mo naman ipakita na billion yung laman ng account mo. Pwede mong i-snip lang yung portion of the page saying na nakabayad ka na, tapos ipadala mo dun sa recipient. A lot better than using print screen, which just takes up the entire screen, tapos ano pang information na mapadala mo. Windows key plus the number, this corresponds to the program na naka-lock sa taskbar mo. So in my case, the first program is Windows Explorer. Para mabuksan ko yan, all I need to do is Windows key and the number 1 key. My fourth program is Word. So para mabuksan yan, I just need to press Windows key and then the number 4 key. So an easy way to access the programs that you have pinned to the taskbar. Actually, Windows key Shift E opens up Explorer already. So I actually don't need that pinned to my taskbar. Control Alt Shift D. A bit complicated and it's a bit geeky, pero masaya tingnan. If you're in Netflix, you can use this shortcut to see the details behind the stream, kung yung bitrate, how many frames have dropped, and a lot of other under the hood kind of details. To be honest, I don't understand 95% of the information there, but it's nice to see na available naman siya kung interested ka. From play to work, Control Shift End is for Excel para tumalon ka dun sa pinakahuling cell na may data. And it will also highlight the data in between the cell that you were at and the last cell. Medyo takot lang ako dun sa highlight aspect because that means that data is selected. Kung maaaring mabura, maaaring mabago. So do use Control S before you use Control Shift N. Para lang sigurado. Finally, if you just remember one shortcut, let it be this one. Windows key and the letter D. This minimizes all of your active programs and sends you back to the desktop. If someone is coming and you've been gaming, watching, or basically doing anything you shouldn't have been doing on the computer, Windows key plus D is the ultimate clutch move. Mawawala yan lahat, babalik ka sa wallpaper, siguraduhin mo lang na safe for work yung wallpaper mo. The next step beyond keyboard shortcuts would be making your own. These are basically macros or a list of instructions or actions that execute when you press a customized keystroke. If you're interested in that, please say so in the comments. Baka gawa tayo ng video about Windows Auto Hotkey or other similar scripting or macro programs. Kung nakatulong tong video na to, we do have other videos on keyboards that we've reviewed, as well as hardware tips on how to get the most out of your hardware, ano ba yung okay na mag-upgrade na okay din yung presyo. A list of those videos nasa baba dito sa text description. Thanks for watching. And thank you to our top fans! Na-afford na namin itong upuan na to! Hindi, joke lang. Thank you to Leah Magnaye, Ian Meru, ITX Addict, John Ruben Ocha, Christian Espinosa, and Rafael James. Thank you for supporting the channel.